We want to determine an equation for a possible trig function from the table of values. Now we just did this problem and we used the cosine function. Now we'll do the same problem and use the sine function. So the first step is going to be to plot these points on the coordinate plane so we can see how these points are behaving. So here's the point 0, 4, 2, negative 2, 4, negative 8, 6, negative 2, 8, 4, 10, negative 2, and 12, negative 8. So right away, based upon the behavior of these points, it should remind us of the sine function or cosine function as we see here. Here's the sine function in blue, and here's the cosine function in red. So if we were to connect these points so they behave like the sine or cosine function, it would look something like this. Let's start by sketching the midline, which would be the horizontal line halfway between the maximum of positive 4 and minimum of negative 8. So the midline would be y equals negative 2. Again, in the last video, we noticed that since there's a maximum value on the y-axis, if we start here at the y-axis, this piece resembles the cosine function. But just to show we can also use the sine function, notice if we start at x equals 2, the graph starts at the midline, then the next point is the minimum, the next point is at the midline, the next point is a maximum, and the next point is back to the midline. Which means if we focus on this piece of the graph, we can write a function involving sine for the table of values. But notice if we do this, we will have to shift our graph right 2 units, so we begin at the midline. So again, if we take a quick look at the sine function here in blue, notice how it starts at the midline, and then a maximum, midline, minimum, and midline. So our function has also been reflected across the x-axis. But now that we know we want to use the sine function to model the table, we need to find the value of a, b, d, and c. So for a quick review, for both the sine and cosine function, the absolute value of a is equal to the amplitude, 2 pi divided by b is equal to the period of the graph. The value of c affects the vertical shift up or down. If c is positive, the graph is shifted up. If c is negative, the graph is shifted down. And then d affects the horizontal translation or horizontal shift, sometimes called the phase shift. Where if we have x minus d, the shift is right. And if we have x plus d, the shift is left. So going back to our graph, let's see if we can identify the values of a, b, d, and c. Well, the absolute value of a is equal to the amplitude, which is the distance from the midline to the maximum, or the distance from the midline to the minimum, which we can see is 6 units. But because this is the sine function reflected across the x-axis, a won't be positive 6, a will be negative 6. Again, this is because starting at the midline, the next point is a minimum, but on the basic sine function, the next point would be a maximum, which means the graph is reflected across the x-axis. Next, to determine the value of b, we need to recognize that from x equals 2 to x equals 10, the graph completes one cycle and then starts to repeat. Therefore, the period is equal to 8, which means 2 pi divided by b must equal 8. So we need to solve this equation to determine b. So we multiply both sides by b, we would have 2 pi equals 8b, divide both sides by 8. So we have b equals, this simplifies to 1 pi over 4, or just pi over 4. Next, let's consider the value of d. Remember, d affects the shift left or right. Because we're using the sine function, the graph has been shifted right 2 units, which means this must be in the form of x minus 2, and therefore d will be positive 2. It's positive because the minus sign is already in the form of the equation. And then finally, the value of c affects the shift up or down. Since the midline is y equals negative 2, the graph is shifted down 2 units. Therefore, c is equal to negative 2. Now that we have the values of a, b, d, and c, we can write the equation of our function. The equation of our function using sine would be f of x equals negative 6 times sine of pi over 4 times the quantity x minus 2 minus 2. So now that we've done this using both the sine and cosine function, I think you'll agree it's a little more straightforward using the cosine function because we didn't have a phase shift or a reflection across the x-axis. Hope you found this explanation helpful.